Hey everybody, we're back at the Temple 420 Bible Study and Torah Tour. We've got our torches, we've got our fragrant incense, and we're at the call of Jeremiah. We're going to do one final wrap up for the tour of today and summarize the calling of somebody, one of the prophets, Jeremiah for this instance, and see how that relates to what we're doing. So grab your big old bong and your torch and your Statue of Liberty and open up your mind and open up your heart and start to believe. The cannabis is good, the land of Cana. In Exodus 13, it's good. And here's Bob Marley talking about Exodus. Maybe we fell, we have to stand up, dust ourselves off, and go straight home, rounding third and not stopping and not looking back. Tribulation right now. All right, so what happens for the calling of Jeremiah? Well, God starts the scene off, because it's a play, remember. So we're learning how this scene, and I'm just going to play the part of God, and then I'll play the part of Jeremiah. I know both parts. So he says, before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Alas, sovereign Lord, I don't know how to speak. I'm just a teenager, 20-year-old or 30-year-old. I could never speak the words of God. Do not say you are too young and you cannot speak. You must go to everyone I send you to and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you. I will rescue you. Then the Lord touched my mouth and said to me, I have put my words in your mouth. What do you see, Jeremiah? I see a branch, your son, the great Emmanuel. You have seen correctly, for I am watching to see if my word, kene bosom, is fulfilled with the oil of joy and gladness. A little ad-libbing. Then God said to me, what do you see, Charlie? I see the branch on fire, its pot boiling like burning, cooking. It is tilting, rising toward the north. It is a fragrant incense rising. Because I had sinned against you, Hashem, because I had done wickedness and I had forgotten you. In fact, I didn't even know who you were until I read your book. But now that I know who you are, and I see everything you do, wow, I would love to join your team. And I could actually sit down and ask you questions and have the mind answer and have a conversation like a five-year-old tea party as an adult and not really go out of his mind, but really truly believe that this is happening? Yes, you have heard correctly, Charlie. Because of the wickedness that you did in forsaking me, in burning incense, and getting stoned, and getting drunk, and partying, and remember that day at your 21st birthday, and remember you puking on the side of that, and what about the porcelain god? You have another god? Remember the porcelain god that you bowed down to the porcelain god how many times in college? Way too many times, Hashem. Though you remind me, how do I avoid my memories? I will blot them out if you obey my commands and not worship foreign gods and not do foolish things and obey and read my Torah and worship me and worship what my hands have made. So get yourself ready and stand up and say to them, whatever I command you, do not be terrified by them, or I will terrify you before them. Today I have made you a fortified city, an iron pillar, a scepter, a bronze wall to stand against the whole land, against the kings of Judah, its officials, its priests, and the people of the land. And they will fight against you, but you will overcome them. For I am with you, and I will rescue you, declared my Lord to me. Because I read, and I believe, and I breathe the aromatic incense that I take to the temple every day, and I come and do these videos before you. I totally hope you love them, man, because it's just one of those videos on demand. If you want it, subscribe to The Air. Be a subscriber if you like The Air, the video. If you don't like it, do me a favor. I would like you to either thumbs up or thumbs down. Let me know, and I want to count, because then I know in my head I'm speaking the words of God. Who doesn't like them? Who's bold enough to say something positive? So, I am pro-sativa, and at that point I'm very positive, with a lot of positive energy, positive thoughts, positive ideas, all planted because God had this crazy plan to create a planet full of his plant. See how the words become like a harvesting, sowing seed process? Yes, the kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. If you have faith, as great as a hemp seed on fire. So, we'll round it out. We'll give thanks to God, and we'll say Baruch Hashem for the almond branch, the pot, the pillar, the gates opening and allowing the aroma to come in, and then burning incense to Hashem and being called, and never putting the phone down again. It's sort of like falling asleep with the girl I did when I was in 12 years old or 13 years old, 15 at that point. No, 16. Yes, 16, just driving. At that point, we just went back and forth until about 6 a.m. You guys remember those days, right? Well, that's where your mind goes when you flood it with the aroma that is pleasing, satisfying. Welcome to roasting chestnuts on an open fire. Here we go. We'll finish it out with a song. We'll end the tour. Maybe at the 840 mark. Who knows? You have to understand that Jeremiah was called. Ezekiel was called. I have been called. I've been anointed with the oil. I can spell the oil. I can go backwards and forwards in four, five, six languages. I didn't know any of this 3 years ago. It's kind of cool to share it with you guys. I hope you enjoy it. I love it. Baruch Hashem. Sold my soul to the devil. I bought it back. I paid my debt back to God, and he welcomed me with open arms, and he said, kiss me, my son. Baruch Hashem.